ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥಾರ್ಯ ಕವಿತಾರ್ಕಿಕ ಕೇಸರಿ ವೇದಾಂತಾಚಾರ್ಯ ವರ್ಯೋ ಮೇ ಸನ್ನಿಧತ್ತಾಂ ಸದಾ ಹೃದಿ. ಟುಡೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ವರ್ಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 22 ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಯಾಮನಾಚಾರ್ಯಸ್ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರ ರತ್ನಂ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಟ್ರೆಪಿಡೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿಯರ್, ವಿತ್ ಭಯಂ, ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಕಮೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರಂ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರಂ ನಂಬರ್ 22. And it is a performance of Sharanagati by Yamunacharya in this, through this slokam. Very deep, very esoteric, very simple, quite pointive, and extremely reinforcing and a reminder for all of us. So let's commence with praying to Acharya for blessing us with the right strength, understanding of this verse. So Perumal says, you have jnana vairagyam, and unless, though you have that, unless you perform the deed as prescribed in sastras and anticipate merely my daya as the sole reason for moksham, as you mentioned in the last verse, dayaika sindave, it is not possible for me, says Perumal. Otherwise there will be partiality, and I will be considered biased towards few if I just choose to grant them moksham. Perumal appears to be saying, further investigating and analyzing this Perumal's ajna and instruction, Alavandar finds that he does not possess any qualification or capability to perform bhakti yogam for attaining moksham. And as a prerequisite for bhakti yogam, he does not even qualify for karma jnana yogam and feels completely remorse and regrets for the same. Taking that helplessness as the very reason and qualification, or the lack of it, he performs his ultimate unflinching sharanagati, prabhati, bharanyasam, self-surrender through this verse. Na dharmanishtosmi, na cha atmavedi, na bhaktiman, tvascharanaravinde, akinchanaha, ananyagatihi sharanya, tutpadamolam, sharanam prabhadhye. Lord Sriman Narayana, sarvaloka sharanya, the only one who is the most worthy of being sought after as the sole refuge, I am not capable of performing karma yoga. Na dharma nishtosmi, na cha atmavedi, not capable of performing jnana yoga. Na bhaktiman, nor do I have even an iota or semblance of bhakti, devotion, performance of bhakti yoga contemplating on your lotus feet, and hence I cannot perform bhakti yoga as well. Hence no other ways or means. Akinchanan, with completely, with utter helpless, I have no other refuge for me except you. Ananyagatihi, I have nobody else. I have formed up my mind and surrendered at your lotus feet as the only upayam. Tvatpadamoolam sharanam prapadye, I have surrendered. So, in Vishishtadvaita, the souls are classified as mukta, baddha, nitya. Nitya are like the eternal souls in Sri Vaikuntham, like Garuda, Vishwaksena. Muktas are those who have attained moksham from here, who were like us but have attained. And baddhas, the samsaris, who are yet to become muktas like us. So in order to achieve moksham, the baddhas like us may choose the bhakti yogam or the prabhati, as declared in Ahidbhujna Samhita and in the Sastras. And as Jnani Bhakti Yoga, as a Jnani knows the rigors of Bhakti Yoga, it requires immense strength, discipline, dhyana, mental concentration, and all that is required as a sadhana. And dhyana on his form, quality, with uninterrupted, like a flow of oil. For Bhakti Yoga, the knowledge that God is present in everything and everything belongs to him is essential. Besides upasanam and strength, Bhakti Yoga also call for varna yogyate, and Bhakti Yoga may not qualify, facilitate us to grant, be granted moksha in the same birth. It may take very many births. So Bhakti Yoga, which is an elaborate process, is often compared to like a bridge of hair over a river of fire. So the jiva practicing in this Kali Yuga has very little chance of reaching the goal of liberation over very many births through Bhakti Yoga. And it has Varnashrama qualifications, it has the time qualification, time restraint. So having said that, it should however be emphasized that Bhakti Yogam, which is a sincere and intense thirst for samsleshan with Perumal, it leads to what is known as Parabhakti, resulting from Shastra Jnanam and following a lifestyle as prescribed by Shastras, which in turn deepens the Jnanam, Parajnanam, having been blessed by this, but by a semblance of Darshana at least once, and that you, the soul gets into intense Thwarai and Viraha Thapam, which leads to Parama Bhakti, which is supreme devotion and a deep desire to be with him, to unite with him and to see him again and again without any interruption, like Nammalvar, like Trimangayalvar, like Goda, like Sabari, like Vyasa, like Vashishta, while God has declared that he is the Prapya. So God takes in place of this Bhakti Yogam and he becomes instead of Bhakti Yogam, and we perform Sharanagati. So Mam Ekam Sharanam Vraja Aham Tva Sarva Papebhyo Moksha Ishyame. Thus, there is no other course easier than Sharanagati to reach the lotus feet of Perumal, to attain moksham. It is as described by Perumal himself through Rama, through Varaha, to Krishna as a Charama Slokam, and by Alvar Acharyas, and it is also declared in Veda, Vedantam, Shastrams, Upanishad. This indeed is a real homecoming and relieving for the ignoramuses and the disqualified like us. And this often is compared to the example of the prince who loses his way in the forest, Swami Desikan says in Ragasatraya Saram, while hunting with his father, the king. The infant gets lost. He grows in a hunter's family and he becomes a youth, but he has lost who he was originally. So he becomes a complete in toto hunter, and a passing by Rishi recognizes, looking at the boy and his tejas, and he could not be from a hunter's descent, could not be from the family, and from the symbols, or from, by talking to him or by seeing some semblance in him, he restores the prince back to the king. In this example, the forlorn prince represents us, the Jivatma, the Rishi as the Acharya whom we approach for Prapatti Sharanagati, and the king is the Supreme Sriman Narayana himself. Like the prince who after reunion, samsleshan, enjoys all the pleasures of the palace, we will also experience the wonderful Sri Vaikuntha Prapti, or here itself being the princely life, being with Bhagavad Anubhavam, Bhagavad Kalyana Gunamrita Vaibhavam, and Bhagavad Aradhanam with Ananya Prayojana Kaikaryam. The thing to notice is that unlike the prince, we can never become the king any day. We would only be the prince, and that would be more wonderful without any responsibility. The supreme merit of Sharanagati just lies in the wonderful universality of its appeal to all, everyone, every being, regardless of caste, creed, class. There is no janma for that, and the guarantee of salvation. Sharanagati applies to everyone, every being, any person, any jantu is like an easy aid, even for a dwarf to reach for a fruit in a tall tree with the help of an acharya. The process of understanding or undertaking or performance of Sharanagati, which is covered by approaching an acharya, familiarizing oneself with the background of the subject, knowing the qualifications, thus is Sharanagati, performance of Sharanagati. one leads a life after performance of the Sharanagati, ever carefree, but expressing one's gratefulness, gratitude to the Acharya, Mahalakshmi and Sriman Narayana every time, as often as possible in one's daily life. Thus, after Prabhati, post-Prabhati period, we need to conduct with Nirbharo Nirbhayosmi, no bharam, no bhayam, no fear, no burden, as if we are waiting for the boat to arrive and take us to the other shore. And during the waiting time, being with them, playing the chess or whatever that they are doing at that shore, with no attachment to the games, but following the rules of the game, performing the Nitya Karma Anushtanam, performing the Ajna Kaingaryam, Anujna Kaingaryam. Thus, Swami Yamunacharya here, performance Satvigatyagam. One should first perform the various kinds of Karma Yoga, like Devarchana, Puja for the Pirmal, for long time. If one does so, and he becomes get to know about who am I, why am I here, what's the purpose, the Jivatma, that is Jnana Yoga. So in order to understand exactly the Jivatma, one should know Ahamatma na Dehosmi, I am the Atma, not the body, and all that. Even in Srimad Ragasya Trayasaram, Swami Desikans, in Mula Mantra Adhikaram, out of 52 qualities of Jivatma, he talks about 18 about Jivan. He talks 52 traits, and then after that, beyond that Jivatma, he talks in the next 18, Swami Desikan. And thus, one should know that the Jivatma eternally is Jnana Swarupi, but it's completely subservient, and it is eternally dependent on Perumal as an attribute, as a servant, and it is to perform Kaikaryam to the Jivatma, but should not get immersed in the Jivatma Anubhavam as Kaivalyam, but should rather go beyond to the infinite absolute bliss of performing Kaikarya Ruchi and enjoying the samsleshama and union with the Paramatma. And what is Atma Nivedanam? Atma Nivedanam is Ahamatma, Nadehosmi, Vishnu Sesho Aparigraha, Tameva Sharanam Prapta, Tatkaikarya Shikirshaya. The Maharishi Vakyam has been taken up in Swanishta Vijnana Adhigaram by Swami Desikan and explains that one should detach himself from the body and consider that Vishnu Sesho Aparigraha is a Sesha of Vishnu, and Tameva Sharanam Prapta, need to perform Sharanagati. Na Bhakti Man Twacharana Ravinde. Emperuman's Bhakti Yogam is talked about here. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, all these things are mentioned in Yoga Sutram and Sri Vishnu Puranam. So all these I am not qualified to perform, Swami Yamunacharya says, because one, I cannot wait for so many births, and hence please understand that the jnana, the karma yogam that transforms once into jnana yogam, and that and takes us to the qualified to perform bhakti yogam, I can do all these things, and hence I am akinchanan. And hence I cannot do anything, and sorry, I am not qualified, nor am I capable of taking up this. And so please consider me as the one who is qualified, because I am not qualified. Who is qualified to be blessed by you as in place of Bhakti Yogam, as you yourself had said, Aham Tva Sarva Papebhyo Moksha Ishyami, Sarva Dharman Parityajya, leave all dharmas and surrender to me. All dharma, what he means here is the Bhakti Yogam, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yogam. Leave that and consider me instead in place of Bhakti Yogam, I would absolve you of all papams and grant you moksham. That is how the Acharyas, Alvas, Vedantams refer to. So, Ananya Gatiki, Sharanya, you are the Sharanya, you are Sarvaloka Sharanya. So, Srimad Bhagavatam, even Emperuman says, Mamekameva Sharanam Atmanam Sarvadehinam Yahi Sarvatma Bhavena Yasyasi Hyakruto Bhayam. So, Tutpada Molam, you are Tirvadi, Nanyam Devam Upasita Vishnoho Paramakaranat Mayam Uttartu Kamo Vai Mayiyo Devata Ganaha. So, see, Vishnu is the Karana Bhutan, for there is no other Devata who is the Karana Bhutan. He is the only one who can get us rid of all future births. Yerutthu Kodiyudayanum, Piramanum, Indiranum, Matrum, Orutharum, Ippiravi Noikku, Marundari Varumilille. Other than Sriman Narayana, the Rishabhavahanan, Rudran, Brahman, Indiran, nobody knows the medicine for this karmic disease. And Marutvanayan Indra Mamani Vanna, the Mamani Vannan, is the one who is the doctor who knows the medicine, who can prescribe the medicine, and he is the one who reinforces the us and puts us back to him, to his lotus feet. So even in Satcharitra Raksha, Sri Sudarsana Panchajanya Dharana Adhikaram, Swami says, Nanyam Devam Upasita, Nanyam Devam Nirikshayete, Nanya Prasadam Arohet, Nanyat Ayatanam Vishet. There is, other than Emperuman, one should not enter into other devatas, perform obeisance to other devatas, have a darshan at other devatas, enter into the residence or place of other devatas. That is Swami Desikan mentions here. So, Kaleshvapicha Sarveshu Dichu Sarvasucha Achyuta Sharirecha Gatau Chapi Vartate Me Mahat Bhayam Totpada Kamala Danyat Anname Janmantareshwapi Nimittam Kushalasyasti Yena Gachami Sadgati. In Jitante Stotram, Sri Shaunakar said, from the Mahatana Bhayam, for the Mahatana Bhayam, in order to get rid of the Bhayam, one needs to perform Saranagati to Emperuman Sriman Narayana, Emperuman's lotus feet. Thus, Akinchanaha Ananya Gatihi Sharanya Tutpadamolam Sharanam Prapadye. And that is what is required in this. After Alavanda, thus here Alavanda perform Prabhati, saying that, oh, you Sriman Narayana, worthy of being sought as refuge, I am not the one established in Dharma. I am not a knower of the self. I have no fervent devotion to your lotus feet to perform Bhakti Yogam. Utterly destitute, utterly incapable as I am, and having no other else, no one else for my, for as a resort, as a refuge, I take performance of Prabhati under your lotus feet. One thing needs to be understood here, which is essential and important. There are two kinds of Dharma, Pravritti Dharma and Nivritti Dharma. Pravritti Dharma is all that leads to material and worldly pursuits, including aspiring for Swargam. While Nivritti Dharma is the act of leading towards Moksham, redemption, salvation, the realization of Jivatma being its true essential nature of subservience to the Paramatma is important, relevant for Moksham, and that's called Tatkratu Nyaya. So, Karma Jnana Yoga is prescribed. Hence, when starting for Karma Yoga with no other aspiring for any other fruit, with Sattvika Tyagam, this will transform into Jnana Bhakti Yoga. So, Karma Jnana Bhakti Yoga or Nivritti Dharma. That's why Lakshmi Tantra shows the three means, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga. So, here Swami performs with five Angas in the Sharanagati. So, in the previous slokam, he says, Namo Namo, that Namaha means I would be an Anukulan for Emperumans, for Bhagavatas, for Acharyas. Thus, Anukulya Sankalpam, Anukulyasa Sankalpam is prescribed. Here he mentions Namas, which means I would always be eternally would not perform any harm or would not perform Bhagavat Bhagavata Acharya Apacharam. Thus, Pratikulya Varjanam is mentioned. Nadharma Nishtosmi. From this Purvartham, it talks about the regret, remorse, and his Karpanyam is referred to. Kripa Janaka Kripana Vrittihi. In order to get the Dhyay from Perumal, one needs to show the remorsefulness, regretness, and hence there is nothing I have to offer, and that is Karpanyam. And also that can be considered as helplessness, Akinchanaha, Ananyagatihi Sharanya. So Akinchanyam, which also gets rid of one's false pride and arrogance by completely saying, I am helpless, please save me. And thereby you become the Garva Hani. And then Swami Desikan mentions this in Parikara Vibhaga Adhigaram in Ragasya Trayasaram. Emperuman, Yappadiyum Adiyenai Kaividamal Kaatharullar. That Mahavishwasam, unflinching faith that he would always protect me under all circumstances at any time. He is the one who is qualified. He is the only one who is qualified. Rakshishyati iti Vishwasaha in Ahir Bhunya Samhita. That is why he says Sharanya, and that is referred to in this Prapadye. Pra, which means Mahavishwasam. Totpadamulam Sharanam Prapadye. Goptritva Varnam is referred to in this Atmanikshevam. This Atma Vastu, you are the only one who can, and this Vastu can be protected only by you. And that is placing that Atma Vastu at his lotus feet, is that Angam is automatically implied here. So with Sangam, Swami performs his wonderful, amazing Sharanagati, and it's a great bhagyam for us to contemplate on Alavanda Sharanagati in this Swami, our Paravakote Srimad Andavan Swami Asmad Acharyan, during the everyday Tiruvaradhanam, at the end of the Tiruvaradhanam, Swami performs his Sashtanga Pranamams to Perumal, to the Shaligrama Perumal, after the Tiruvaradhanam. And while doing that, he used to recite this verse, Nadharma Nishtosmi Nachatma Vedi Bhakti Mantra Charanaravinde Akinchanaha Ananyagadhi Sharanya Tutpadamulam Sharanam Prabadhyam. Namo Narayana Acharyan Trivedikale Sharanam.